Yes, in this video, we'll see how a polynomial can be addition using arrays can be done using C++. Here, as we have seen already in the previous videos, here we declared maximum size to be 10 and we have declared a class called polynomial. And inside that, we declare each term of the polynomial to consist of a coefficient and power. We used a struct data type. And we have given a name for that as term. Then we have declared an array of this term. So we have given name as t and a maximum size 10. So 10 terms. This will accept up to 10 terms for the polynomial. Okay. Now here we have declared a member variable n. And then here this is a constructor where this initially the number of terms. This is used to mention the number of terms for each polynomial. So n equal to 0, and here we initialize the each variable inside the structure. So how you can do, it's an array of this. So t of 0, the first index, and this is a array. It consists of two values, coefficient and number. So that we are making it to be 0. So structure variable you can access through dot, and array, each array value you can access through the index. So we have initialized them to be 0. Then we have used get poly, display and add poly, three member functions where we pass two polynomials and the result will be given to the main program so that we will be printing. Now get poly. Get poly is to read the polynomial. So here using we will call this twice to get to read two polynomials. And then this we have already seen in the previous video how it reads. So number of terms you get, till the number of terms we get the both the coefficient and power, and we assign it to the respective that is instant polynomial instant. The same way display, we will be able to display the polynomial which have received, which have read. Then now this is the main, this is the add poly where we have seen that polynomial p1 p2 will consist of number of terms. After reading this, after getting poly, we'll have this number of terms which is stored in the local and the member variable n. So we first we p1 dot n, by accessing that we can read how many terms in that respective polynomial and assign it to local variables n1 and n2 of polynomial 1 and polynomial 2 respectively. Then polynomial 3 number of terms is made to 0, because now only we are going to add. After that only, after full addition of both this only, we will know what is the number of terms. So here till the so I j, we initialized I j k to be 0. Each I is for p1, j is for p2, and k is for this p3. So number of terms it indicates. So we keep how many, each and every term we do a condition. If both the powers are equal, then we add. Else we write it accordingly. Write it into the third polynomial accordingly. So this, all these things logic we have seen already. Now here so this is if there is any remaining term after addition, sometimes there may be remaining term that also will be added to the third polynomials respectively. Now in the main program we declare the polynomial, we declare instance of this polynomial type p1 p2 p3. Then we call p1 dot get poly. So this first polynomial is got, we read it from the system monitor. Then p2 again, the second polynomial is also read. Then we just print those values, whatever is printed. Then we pass those values to the add poly member functions, and this return the polynomial 3. So that is what here we do, return p3, and then we are displaying with this function display. Now we'll see how it executes. Now we'll see how to execute. I am giving a value 3 terms, number of terms for the first polynomial is 3. Now I give 5 and then 2 and 3, second term 1 and then 2 term is 0, power is 0. Now I am reading for the second polynomial. The number of terms is again, it is 3, then coefficient, then 3, then 9, 2, 5 and 1. Now if you see this, this is the polynomial, first polynomial I have entered, 5x squared, 3x1, 2x, 2, constant, this x power is 0, so it is a constant 2. Second polynomial is 10x cubed, 9x squared and 5x. When you add these two, you will get 10x cubed. And then these two, same power are added. So likewise, same power are added. And then this last constant is returned. So this is your output. So this is your output. Initially, we read number of terms. See how we are getting. If it is a constant, you have to give the power as 0. So likewise, we have added. These two are added and this is the third polynomial.